In some ways, 1969 Topps baseball cards must have seemed familiar to collectors that spring. On one hand, the set shared the big photos, similar design tenets of the classic 1967 set. On the other, it featured many of the similar photos, some identical to those of the 1968 set, along with the circles and curved inner borders. Thankfully or not, depending on your tastes, the burlap was gone. But 1969 Topps also had a look all its own, as the photography was some of the most crisp of the era, and the blazing white borders made the whole thing super clean. Ooh, and pink cardbacks. When it comes to card values, the 1969s generally don't stand up to the sets around them, with one exception. Several cards exist in the white letter variations, where players' first and last names were in white letters instead of whatever colors they were actually planned in. Those error cards can fetch a pretty penny today, but they're the exception, so I'm not including them here in our list of the most valuable 1969 Topps baseball cards. Instead, what follows are the normal, non-white letter base cards that sell for the most in PSA 7, as reported in the PSA Sports Market Report Price Guide. 1969 Topps Reggie Jackson rookie card number 260. The 1969 set is pretty much devoid of big-name rookies, with this one glaring, mustard-covered, hot-dogged exception. I mean, baseball names didn't get much bigger than Reggie in the 70s and early 1980s, and this rookie card is unusual for the time, given that it's a solo flight. As Reggie became Mr. October and marched towards the Hall of Fame, this swatch of cardboard became a hobby staple, and today it sells for $400 or more in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Mickey Mantle, number 500. This is Mantle's last Topps card, issued just about the time he announced his retirement. It features a classic shot of the Mick at bat and has become an iconic image in the hobby. You can expect to pay close to $400 for a PSA 7 copy. 1969 Topps Nolan Ryan, number 533. The 1968 Topps Nolan Ryan rookie card is one of the absolute monsters of the hobby, but his 1969 Topps second year issue is actually a much better baseball card. For one thing, it's Ryan's first solo card. For another, it's big and bright and shows young Nolan in good effect. And for third, the burlap is gone. So is this all just an opinion? Mostly, I guess, but enough folks love this one to make it a $200 card in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Johnny Bench, number 95. Like Ryan above, Bench gets his first solo cardboard in the 1969 Topps set, and the card is another winner. Showing Bench in his crouch, this shot makes the Cincinnati Reds legend look more like an actor playing a catcher, what with his perfect rebel hair and all. The Topps All-Star Rookie Trophy sets things off nicely. No wonder this thing checks in around $100 in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Willie Mays, number 190. In 1966, Topps treated collectors to a smiling image of Mays, apparently popping a ball into his glove. They liked that shot so much, apparently, that they brought it back for '69. Never mind that, though, because both cards look great, and the 1969 sells for about $80 in graded near mint condition. 1969 Topps Roberto Clemente, number 50. What's not to love about this card? The pirate's vest, the steely stare into the future of a baseball legend, the perfect blue sky framing Clemente. All great stuff, and although I still have trouble with the Topps use of Bob, that hasn't really kept this card from reaching $65 plus in PSA 7. 1969 Topps, Hank Aaron, number 100. Another holdover photo. This one shows the all-time home run king with his hat sitting high and wary eyes keeping track of something off to his left. Even with the duplication, it's a classic shot of a man on the verge of a fantastic run into history. For that, expect to pay $65 or so for PSA 7 specimens. 1969 Topps, Tom Seaver, number 480. Yet another repeat photo graces this third-year issue of Tom Terrific, a perfect match to his 1968 second-year piece. For my money, though, the minimal 1969 design elements, including the yellow Mets at the card bottom, makes this the best of Seaver's 1960s cards. Doesn't hurt that this was the card collectors pulled during the Amazing Mets' amazing run to the 1969 World Series Championship. In PSA 7, this one goes for around $65 today. 1969 Topps Lou Brock, number 85. There's a ton going on in this photo on this card, and from all the intricacies of the Cardinals logo, to the netting of the batting cage, to the player, Mike Shannon, taking hacks behind Brock. It all works to great effect, though, and the result is a classic card of the Hall of Fame speedster. This is about a $60 piece in PSA 7 these days. 1969 Topps Pete Rose, number 120. Pete Rose screwed things up to biblical degree, but he's still a legend. And his card almost always appears near the top of any value chart for whichever set it appears in. This clean-looking 1969 is no exception and usually sells for about $50 plus in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Carl Yastrzemski, number 130. Yaz was nearly 2 years removed from his Triple Crown season by the time this 1969 Topps card emerged from wax packs, but he was still one of the monster superstars of the game. Not much has changed in that regard over the decades, and today this classic follow-through pose brings in $45 or so in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Rolly Fingers rookie card, number 597. We already spilled past our normal top 10 with Yaz above, so why not include one more? Especially since it's a rookie card of a pitching legend, showing him before his patented handlebar took over his face. Fingers shares his rookie card with Bob Floyd and Larry Burchart, which doesn't seem to have affected the pasteboard value much one way or another. It's a $40 plus item in PSA 7. 1969 Topps Mickey Mantle, white letter variation, number 500. And since we've already blown away past our limit here, we'll break our own rules and include this white letter mantle as an honorable mention. You won't find many of these error cards on the market, but when you do, even a PSA 7 copy can set you back $3,000 or more. Like our video? Then like our videos and subscribe to our channel. WaxPackGods.com